Good morning, students. It gives me great pleasure to talk to you students through video presentation like this. Let me take just an example on integration. Just listen carefully. I am given x square dx divided by x plus 1 into x plus 2. Practically speaking, if I multiply the whole lot in the denominator, it is reduced to x square plus 3x plus 2. X plus 2x is 3x. Therefore, it is as equal as one of the cases I did in the previous video. That is, I have to divide and then proceed. Instead, since they are of equal degree here, numerator is of equal degree as compared to the denominator. What I will try to do here is add 3x plus 2 and subtract 3x plus 2. Dx divided by x square plus 3x plus 2. I can make it as separate integral, x square plus 3x plus 2 divided by x square plus 3x plus 2 dx minus integral 3x plus 2 dx divided by, here I will write this as x plus 1 into x plus 2. Here it will get cancelled, therefore I will start with I. Here I call it as I1. Okay, in I1, just listen. What I will do is, I will apply partial fractions. Let 3x plus 2 divided by x plus 1 into x plus 2 to be is equal to a upon x plus 1 plus b upon x plus 2. After taking LCM, 3x plus 2 happens to be is equal to capital A into x plus 2 plus capital B into x plus 1. Name this as equation 1. Name this as equation 1. Now, to get the values of a and b, forget about the previous steps. If such a case arises, 3x plus 2 is equal to capital A into x plus 2 plus capital B into x plus 1. How to get the values of a and b? Now, substitute x is equal to minus 2 in 1. What do I get? Minus 6 plus 4 happens to be minus 4 is equal to 0 plus b into minus 1. For b happens to be 4. Now substitute x equal to minus 1 in 1. What do I get? This will become minus 1 is equal to a plus 0. Therefore, a happens to be minus 1. A happens to be minus 1. Therefore, the whole integral now will become I is equal to x minus of minus 1 will plus 1. Integral, I will write this as d of x plus 1 by x plus 1. Now my b is 4, there is a minus sign here. Now for minus 4 integral d of x plus 2 by x plus 2, now for the whole thing will get reduced to x log x plus 1 plus log x plus 1 minus 4 log x plus 2 plus c. Let me check the calculations over here. I repeat, I'm given x square dx by x plus 1 and x plus 2. If I multiply the denominator, x plus 2x becomes 3x, 1 into 2 is 2. The numerator is of equal degree as compared to the denominator in this case. What I will try to do here is, I will add 3x plus 2 and subtract 3x plus 2. Instead, I should do long division. Even if I do long division, my quotient will be 1, my remainder will be minus 3x plus 2. Both are equivalent. Doing this way directly and dividing and proceeding, both are equivalent. Integral dx gets reduced to x. Here I call this is I1. Here I will take the whole quantity as capital A by x plus 1 plus capital B by x plus 2. After taking LCM, 3x plus 2 will be equal to capital A into x plus 2 plus capital B into x plus 1. It doesn't write properly, just listen carefully. Now, to get the values of A and B, I take this separate situation I already told you in some of the videos earlier. Okay, put x equal to minus 2. Minus 6 plus 2 happens to be minus 4. This is 0. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. B is reduced to 4. Put x equal to minus 1 or substitute x equal to minus 1. Minus 3 plus 2 is minus 1. Here it is 2 minus 1 is 1. For A is reduced to minus 1. Now for the whole integral, now I will be equal to x minus of minus 1 is plus integral d of x plus 1 by x plus 1. Then b value is 4, minus 4 d of x plus 2 by x plus 2 integral of that. For x plus log x plus 1 minus 4 log x plus 2 plus c. If you want to group your coefficients fully, I mean logarithmic quantities fully, I can even write this as x plus log x plus 1 divided by x plus 2 power 4 plus c. That is also correct. Using your power rule here and division rule of logarithms continuously. I think it's clear for anybody to follow. It's not at all difficult for anybody to understand. Anyway, let me take an example here. X cube dx divided by x plus 1 into x plus 4. Just listen carefully. Actually, practically speaking, here my numerator is of greater degree. Here again, I will write my dividend here. What is the product in the denominator? It's reduced to x square plus 5x plus 4. X plus 4x happens to be 5x. 4 into 1 is 4. Let me divide. Let me do long division. X cube by x square is x. Here I'll get reduced to x cube plus 5x square plus 4x. While you subtract, this will get cancelled. This is reduced to minus 5x square minus 4x. Okay, 0 minus plus 5 is minus 5x, minus 5x square. Okay, minus 5x square by x square is minus 5. While you multiply, what do I get? I will get minus 5x square, minus into minus 5, minus 25x, minus 20. While I subtract, it gets reduced to 21x plus 20. Therefore, just use the rule dividend by divisor is equal to quotient plus remainder by divisor. Therefore, my whole integral x cube dx divided by whole integral x cube dx divided by x plus 1 into x plus 4 will get reduced to, just listen carefully, what is my quotient? X minus 5 dx. Okay, then what is my remainder? Integral 21x plus 20 dx. Here I will write this as x plus 1 into x plus 4. Just listen what I have written is right or wrong. X cube by x square is x. X into x square is x cube. X into 5x is 5x square. X into 4 is 4x. While I subtract, 0 plus of minus 5 is minus 5x square. 0 minus 4x is plus of minus 4x. Minus 4x is minus 4x. Minus into plus becomes minus. Therefore, again, minus 5x square of x square is minus 5. Minus 5 into x square is minus 5x square. Minus 5 into 5 is minus 25x. Minus 5 into 4 is minus 20. While I subtract, minus 4 plus 25 happens to be 21x. 0 minus of minus 20 happens to be 20. Now, for using this rule, dividend by divisor equal to quotient plus remainder by divisor. My quotient is x minus 5 plus my remainder is 21x plus 20 divided by, I'll write this way. Let me talk about the original integral as I. Okay, here it's reduced to x square by 2 minus 5x plus I1 plus I1. Let it be. Let me do my I1 part by rubbing off this. Let me do my I1 part by rubbing off this quantity. Okay, just listen. In I1, what I will do here is, let 21x plus 20 divided by x plus 1 into x plus 4 to be is equal to a by x plus 1 plus b by x plus 4. Therefore, my 21x plus 20 will be is equal to a into x plus 4 plus b into x plus 1. Name this is equation 1. Again, to get the values of a and b, let me forget about the previous steps. What happens to my value of a and b when only this case is taken? Just put substitute x equal to minus 1 in 1. What do I get? Minus 1 is equal to 3a plus 0. For a happens to be minus 1 by 3. Substitute x is equal to minus 4 in 1. What do I get? This will become minus 84. Am I right? 4 in 21 is 84. Minus 84 plus 20. This is reduced to minus 64. Minus 84 plus 20 is minus 64. Is equal to 0 plus b into minus 3. which implies B happens to be 64 by 3. Therefore, my whole integral I will now get reduced to x square by 2 minus pi x. What is my A? Minus 1 by 3. Minus 1 by 3 integral d of, what is the first quantity? X plus 1. D of x plus 1 by x plus 1. What is my B? 64 by 3. 64 by 3 integral d of x plus 4 by x plus 4, which will get reduced to anyway x square by 2 minus 5x minus 1 by 3 log mod x plus 1 plus 64 by 3 log mod x plus 4 plus c. Let me repeat the whole process. After division, it gets reduced to x minus 5 plus remainder by divisor. This is my quotient. Now integral x dx is x square by 2. 5 dx is 5x. Then for the rest of the things, I am continuing here. 21x plus 20 by x plus 1 at x plus 4 is a by x plus 1, b by x plus 4. After taking LCM, 21x plus 20 is equal to capital A into x plus 4 plus capital B into x plus 1. Now substitute x equal to minus 1 here. Minus 21 plus 20 becomes minus 1 is equal to 4. Minus 1 happens to be 3. 3a plus 0. A is minus 1 by 3. Substitute x equal to minus 4 here. Minus 84 plus 20 happens to be minus 64. Here it is minus 4 plus 1 is minus 3. Therefore b gets reduced to 64 by 3. Let me continue here to think about I. I is x square by 2 minus 5x. I have to continue with I1 over here with the values of a and b. Minus 1 by 3 into d of x plus 1 by x plus 1 plus 64 by 3 into d of x plus 4 by x plus 4. Therefore, the whole integral now gets reduced to x square by 2 minus 5x minus 1 by 3 log mod x plus 1 plus 64 by 3 log mod x plus 4 plus c. I think it's very easy for anybody to follow. It's not at all difficult. Therefore, I have chosen three different cases. The last part of your earlier video, I took an example. Numerator is of equal degree as compared to the denominator, and in the denominator I am trying to make it as a perfect square. I am doing the second part, numerator equal to a into d by dx of denominator plus b. I applied here, I am able to split the denominator, and for the second part I want, I am using partial fractions separately. And I have chosen in another example here, and at the beginning itself, they are of equal degree, add the necessary quantities and subtract so and so. That makes the further integration becomes to be easier. Further integration to be easier. Just listen carefully. Now, there are three different special integrals. Just listen. Let me take an example. Just take a simple thing. Integral root of a square minus x square dx. Let me try to continue, see how I am going to continue with this thing. What I will do here is put x equal to a sin theta. Now dx will be a cos theta d theta. Let me continue with the original integral root of a square minus x square dx, which is root of integral root of a square minus a square sin square theta. This is again a cos theta d theta. Now this is also reduced to a cos theta. A cos theta into a cos theta d theta. Therefore this is reduced to a square into integral cos square theta d theta. I can very well write this as integral 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2 d theta. It's not at all difficult for anybody to follow. Now this is reduced to two integrals, a square by 2 integral d theta plus a square by 2 integral cos 2 theta d theta. Therefore this is reduced to a square by 2 theta plus a square by 2, this is reduced to sin 2 theta by 2 plus c. Therefore this is reduced to a square by 2. What is my theta? X by a is sin theta. Theta is sin inverse x by a. Here again, I will write this as a square by 2 into 2 sin theta cos theta by 2. 1, 2 gets cancelled, which is equal to a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus, here again a square by 2 into, I will write sin theta by x by a, this is as 1 minus sin square theta plus c. This is reduced to a square by 2 into sin inverse x by a. 1 a already gets cancelled. For a by 2 into x into root of 1 minus, this is x square by a square plus c. Here again, this is reduced to anyway a square by 2 sin inverse x by a. This is a square by 2 sin inverse x by a. Just listen, a square by 2 sin inverse x by a. Okay, this is a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus a by 2 into x into root of a square minus x square by a. This is also getting cancelled. I will write this as the first step. Therefore, the whole integral now will get reduced to x by 2 root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus c. That I get it as a formula. Integral root of a square minus x square dx is x by 2 root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus c. I repeat the whole process. I take x equal to a sin theta. Dx happens to be a cos theta d theta. Substitute here x as a sin theta, therefore this is also reduced to a cos theta, this is also a cos theta. For a square integral, this is anyway cos square theta, this is simply cos square theta, okay, this is simply cos square theta. Now what I intend to do here is a square integral 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2 d theta. Now I will make it as two different integrals, okay, this is a square by 2 integral d theta plus a square by 2 integral cos 2 theta d theta. For a square by 2 theta plus a square by 2 sin 2 theta by theta, 2 plus c. Therefore, this theta is sin inverse x by a from this. Now, here I will write this is 2 sin theta cos theta using a sin 2a formula. Okay, now for a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus a square by 2 into sin theta is x by a, cos theta in terms of sin is 1 minus sin square theta. A square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus 1 a already gets cancelled. A by 2 x root of 1 minus x square by a square. Take LCM, this a also gets cancelled. Therefore, the whole integral will get reduced to x by 2 root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus c. That is like a formula, in fact. That is like a formula you should not forget. Let me just take an example. Integral root of 25 minus x square dx. This is reduced to root of 5 square minus x square dx. What do I end up with? This is x by 2 root of 25 minus x square plus a square by 2. Now for 25 by 2 is reduced to sin inverse x by 5 plus c. 25 by 2 sin inverse x by 5 plus c. Let me repeat. This 25 can be written as pi square. Apply the formula which I derived just now. X by 2 root of 25 minus x square plus 25 by 2 sin inverse x by 5 plus c. That is the answer to be followed. This may be just given for one mark, if at all possible, to be given in your board examination. Okay, let me just take another example. Okay, just listen carefully. What I will do here is integral root of x square plus a square dx. What I intend here is put x equal to a tan theta. Therefore, dx will become a secant square theta d theta. Dx will become a secant square theta d theta. Okay, therefore let me go back. I consider this as I root of x square plus a square dx, which is root of, here it is, a square tan square theta plus a square. This is reduced to a secant square theta d theta. This is reduced to simply a secant theta. This is already into a secant square theta d theta. My a square is taken out. I will write this as d of tan theta, because I am going to apply my integration by parts. I am going to think of my integration by parts principle. Therefore, I will write this as d of, I will write this as d of tan theta. Okay. Now apply integration by parts. What do I get? A square secant theta tan theta minus a square integral tan theta d of secant theta. Since recall the formula, integral u dv is equal to uv minus integral v du. And here, what is my u? Instead of u, I have secant theta. Instead of me, I have v, I have tan theta. Okay, let me continue here. Therefore, this is anyway reduced to a square secant theta tan theta. Okay, minus a square into tan theta into, what is the derivative of secant theta? Secant theta tan theta d theta. Therefore, here again, this is simply reduced to, okay, a square secant theta tan theta minus a square integral secant theta into, this is reduced to secant square theta minus 1 d theta. Secant square theta minus 1 d theta. Just listen carefully. Therefore, this is anyway reduced to a square secant theta tan theta minus a square integral secant cube theta d theta minus into minus plus a square integral secant theta d theta. Therefore, let me write my LHS. I is equal to a square secant theta tan theta. This is again my I. Along with a square, it is my I. Minus I plus a square. I can write two more steps here. Multiply and divide by secant theta plus tan theta. Therefore, this will get reduced to simply log mod secant theta plus tan theta plus C1. I'll tell you the purpose of writing C1. Listen carefully. Let me check the whole answer. Put x equal to a tan theta. Dx is a secant square theta d theta. For integral root of x square plus a square dx is a square tan square theta plus a square d a secant square theta d theta. This is reduced to a secant theta. There is one a secant square theta already here. A square integral, this secant square I write as d of tan theta to apply my formula of integration by parts. After applying the formula of integration by parts, it gets reduced to a square secant theta tan theta minus a square integral tan theta d of secant theta. Okay, u dv, uv minus integral v du. Sorry. Now, this is a square secant theta tan theta minus a square integral tan theta. What is derivative of secant theta? Secant theta tan theta d theta. Therefore, I can very well write this tan square theta secant theta square theta minus 1. Write it as separate integrals again. A square secant theta tan theta minus a square integral secant cube theta d theta plus a square integral secant theta d theta. Now, this is along with a square. This is my I. Check here. This is my a square secant cube theta is my I. Integral this much is my I. A 4 is reduced to minus I plus a square into. Here again, you are allowed to multiply and divide by secant theta plus tan theta. Two more steps you write. Write two more steps. Okay, write two more steps over here. And a 4 taking my I to the other side to LHS. 2i happens to be a square secant theta tan theta plus a square log mod secant theta plus tan theta plus c1. Just listen carefully. Okay, let me just continue here. Okay, what I will try to here to do here is I will write every term in terms of tan theta. I am trying to bring everything in terms of tan theta. Therefore, this is a square into root of 1 plus tan square theta, root of 1 plus tan square theta into tan theta, plus a square into log mod, this is root of 1 plus tan square theta plus tan theta plus c1. Therefore, this is reduced to a square into root of 1 plus x square by a square into x by a plus a square into log mod root of 1 plus x square by a square plus x by a plus c1. Therefore, this is reduced to a square into, just listen, root of a square plus x square into x by a by a. This a square will get cancelled anyway. Plus a square into log mod x plus root of x square plus a square plus c1 minus log a. This log a is taken along with c1. But I am interested in finding out only I. For I happens to be automatically divide throughout by 2. X by 2 root of a square plus x square plus a square by 2 log mod x plus root of x square plus a square. The remaining quantities I call it as c. C1 by 2 minus half log a, I call it as c. Therefore, let me continue only from this process over here. Okay, I is equal to this much. Grouping I will get 2i. This is 2i. 2i happens to be a square secant theta tan theta plus a square log secant theta plus tan theta plus c1. I am going to replace c1 by everything. So many constants are going to be there. I club everything to make it as c. Now, what I do here is 2i is I will try to bring everything in terms of tan. Is reduced to root of 1 plus tan square theta. Here again root of 1 plus tan square theta. Replace every tan theta by x by a. Now for root of 1 plus x square by a square into x by a. Plus a square log mod root of 1 plus x square by a square plus x by a. Plus c1. Now for a square into take LCM. Root of a square plus x square by a plus x by a. Plus a square log x plus root of x square plus a square plus c1 minus log a. This minus log a is clubbed over here. Am I right? Here again a square log a will you get? Yeah. This is again a square log a. This is again a square log a. Yeah. There is one a square here. Okay. A square log a. Let it be. Now this is divide throughout by 2. X by 2 root of x square plus a square plus a square by 2 log of this. The remaining quantity c1 by 2 minus a square by 2 log a will be taken as simply c. Now for the whole integral now becomes integral root of x square plus a square dx is x by 2 root of x square plus a square plus a square by 2 log mod x plus root of x square plus a square plus c. Okay, this is how you get. Since my pen is not writing properly, my explanation is clear, I understand. Okay, I will just continue with the next video because it's already going to be half an hour or so. I'll continue with the next video. I'll try to continue with some problems under this as well as one more type of derivation. Thank you very much.